Welcome. Today I'm going to use Vim Fugitive to resolve merge conflicts. If you aren't familiar with Fugitive, please see my previous video from last week covering that exactly, which is linked here in the top. I'm starting from one of my projects where I'm currently running on the master branch. I'll create a feature branch to create an intentional conflict. When you make a change in a branch that's going to be merged and then make another change on the original branch, what happens in Git is it's noticing two changes, but their timing doesn't make sense. The branch merged was changed before my current branch, which is master. This is when Git calls a conflict and asks the author to fix it. I could have avoided that by rebasing, which would essentially tell Git that the changes merge should now have a new state at their base. This isn't very complicated, but it's not part of the video, so I'll leave it at that. Having all that said, today we're going into Git merges visually and interactively. So I'll pop back into my master branch after making a change in the other branch, and I want to see Git creating a conflict for us to solve together. So I'll just do another change in master right where I made the change in the old branch, and we'll see what Git says about that. Fast forward through the changes, and once I'm ready, I'm going to merge my new branch into the master one. So now that we have a conflict, let's run Vim and see how we can solve that with Fugitive. I'm navigating to the same file that we made the conflict in, and I can see the standard conflict that Git pops with the head and the other feature branch and the different changes between the two. Now I could solve it manually, but let's go for a split. So once I try a normal split, Vim tells me to use a gdiff split. So I'll do that. And once I have that, you can now see a three-way split. So in the middle, I have my working copy with the changes we've seen before. And to my left, I can see one branch, and to my right, I can see another one. On the left, the file from the target branch, in our case master, will always have //2 in its name. And the file on the right will be the merge branch, which is the feature branch in my case, and that will always have //3. As you can see, I list the buffers and I can see the names and the string that they have in them. These partial matches are sufficient to uniquely identify the target and the merge files, and we can use resolve commands, and we'll now see how we do that exactly. It can get a little confusing, so let's see how it actually works. We start off with the diffget command. This tells Vim to get the changes from a provided target into the working copy, which is where my cursor is currently at. In the context of merge conflicts, when using diffget, I will always stand on my working copy in the middle and then pick one side that I want to pull from. So I made my pick, which is the master branch. Let me undo the changes and repick number 3, which is the pane to the right, and that's my feature branch. Once I've made my pick, I can commit the changes and complete the work. This is a good place to say that if you aren't familiar with all of those Git features I'm using within Vim, the previous video, which I'll link here below or up if you can see it, have all the details and instructions. You can stop the video, watch the other one, and then come back, and it will all look familiar and more understandable. I can now see the changes reflected in the log. Let's open the commit and make sure that the actual changes that I did commit are the ones that I intended to do. And once I see that everything is in order, we can keep going to the next stop. Let's quickly create another conflict and show the diffput command in action. So here I am again in the three-way diff view. I'm usually not bothering with diffput, but it's another option that shows Fugitive's versatility, so I'll show you how it's done. Put is just the opposite of get, in the sense that with get, we used to stand on the working copy and then pull the changes, whereas in this instance, we will go to the target branch or the merge branch and push the changes into the working copy. This may become handy if you want to scroll in one pane and you don't want to jump back and forth when managing multiple conflicts in one file. So that's basically it. I ran diffput into todomd, which is my working copy, and the changes are already there. So lastly, I want to show you a conflict that's running across multiple mistakes that we have in one long file and see the entire workflow that I go through with solving the merge. So a nice thing with jumping between diagnostics, this can help you scroll through the different conflicts that you have in the same file. And that's exactly what I do. Let's zoom out a little bit so we can see the entire thing. And now what I'm gonna do is just jump with the next diagnostics back and forth and start solving my merges. So in this instance, I wanna see my buffers and decide whether I want to use my target branch or my merge branch. And let's just diffget one of the changes. So I'm gonna choose the branch that I'm merging to, as in not the feature branch, master one, which I remind you has //2 in the name. I'll just use that for the auto completion and pick that. And now we can move on to the next conflict. I'm gonna pick the other branch in this instance, the merge branch. So diffget, auto completion, pick the one that has 3 in the name. Again, you can use aliases for that if you want. I don't bother with that. And jumping on to the last conflict, picking one of the branches and finishing the work. This time I'm gonna pick again number 2, which is my master branch in this instance, the branch that I'm merging into, not the one from. And once I'm done, I'll just leave this pane visible. Gwrite will basically add all the hunks and all the changes that I have in the file, ready to commit. Let's write a commit message and finish off the work. I want to bring up the tools that I use for visibility. So with telescope and get commits, I can see the log. You can see that I'm standing on the commit, and to the right, I can see the preview. And once I'm ready, I want to open git log and see the same thing. With equal, I can open the commit. And again, review the changes that I've made in order to make sure that everything's fine. Once I'm ready, this is basically it. Commit and push.